This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza, sliceonbroadway.com. And listeners like you, support this show at patreon.com/awesomecast.
Sidekick Media Services. We are your sidekick in business for social media, video production, and more. Find out more at sidekickmediaservices.com.
Hey guys, it's time to talk tech, get geeky. It is the AwesomeCast. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitter here in the Mayhem Studio in Pittsburgh, PA. It is the show where we talk about gadgets, technology news, and so much more. The awesome things happening in and around Pittsburgh. People using this stuff. Myself, a video producer here in the Pittsburgh area. And with us coming from Studio C, I want to show off this. So we switched to Skype from Google Hangouts, and that 4K, that we're getting closer to the 4Ks. For this for this recorded 720p podcast, so
would you say we're at like 2.5Ks?
I'm trying to get to AK, to be honest.
AK, 1K. So we're still under AK.
Yeah, so we're trying to get to one single K. Sorry. Yes,
we have a K.
We have a K.
She's on the couch.
She is on the couch, K. And she is Katie Dudas. She is the social media extraordinaire over at Scarehouse and helps out with things here at Sorgatron Media as well.
Hi.
Sometimes visits Sawtooth Willie.
Yeah, I gotta do that. I miss him.
Yeah, we gotta get that lined up. With us as well, K Dudders on the Twitters.
Hello.
And of course, Chilla. Not only when he's not on a super sweet webcam, he's a gadget guru over at Big Bank International Incorporated Esquire. And of course, Missy is Missy Sorg helping us out, the producer of the show.
Yes. I tell them what to do and when to do it.
That's right. Keeping all the show notes and keeping the show in line and on the track, because we know how we go off the track on here. But you can check everything out at awesomecast.net. You can email us, so awesomecast@sorgatronmedia.com. Tweet us at awesomecast, awesomecast on the Facebook. You can subscribe and rate us, please, on iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, or the YouTube and Facebook have the video versions of this show. And if you follow the AwesomeCast Facebook page, you get to check us out live whenever I get a guest in the studio, like we did, some pre-announced, but kind of random times last week. Scott McTaggart of Pitchworks is coming up this week, and Scott Simmons of, it was all the Scotts last week, of the Scarehouse joined us, and they'll be coming up here in the coming weeks. On the Awesome Chat. So please subscribe to that and check it out at awesomecast.net as well. And also, we're streaming live two different places now. RiversEdgePGH.com, I believe. Did the schedule change? Did we know yet? Thursdays, 8 a.m. after Funny Money is the old time. But go check with them. They have that going out whenever that is. Check their schedule.
I think that's still
the tweets. Is that still the tweets going through? Okay, still Thursday, 8 a.m. after Funny Money. Or also, we are, I believe it's 9 a.m. Monday through Friday on the 405media.com, our new affiliate. They're also streaming, so please check us out there.
Now, that 9 a.m.
What's that?
That 9 a.m. that you're talking.
Pacific.
So that's noon here.
So
on the East
do
Coast.
Your math. You can listen to AwesomeCast over your lunch break. So thank you so much for those guys. They've been supporting the Wrestling Mayhem show for a good while, and were gracious enough to start carrying the AwesomeCast as well. And you can imagine what havoc we've caused over there with Wrestling Mayhem show. Announcements. With all the gaming,
because
what am I doing?
You need to add a little smidge into your little notes there.
Oh,
because when you're talking about the fact that we're broadcasting via Facebook Live, you should also be telling folks to like the page and share the content that we're putting out there, because we love it. You love it. Your friends will love it too.
That cat on your shoulder loves it.
Yes, the cat. Oh, there he is. Yes, the cat on the shoulder also loves it because it keeps me occupied.
Yes. There you go. So please go check it out. Tell your friends as well. Quick update here. With all the gaming news we've been doing on here, we've been talking about it a lot, and we kind of want to do a, you know, take a little bit of what we learned from InsertCoin to begin and maybe do something a little different. We're looking to do an AwesomeCast kind of gaming spinoff. So we wanted to get some feedback from you guys because we want to make sure it's something that sticks out, something a little different, and maybe something, you know, like this show with a little bit of a Pittsburgh-based flair. So hit us up on our Twitter and Facebook. Let us know, what would you like to see from, like, an AwesomeCast video game focused show? Please let us know over on those, and we'll get something cool rolled out here in the near future in process. Also, hey, big thanks to our friends patreon.com/awesomecast support that are supporting the show, and you guys can too. Matt Weller at the Coffee Club level, he gets the AwesomeCast Gold, as well as the State of the AwesomeCast, and as Mike Fedor at Mike Fedor's show on the Twitter. He's at the fan of show level. Thank you so much. You can give a little, give a lot. If you give a lot, we have some special stuff for you. Check it out over there. And it's not required. You share the show, or however is appreciated as well. So let's get into, speaking of gaming, in the meantime, though, there's a lot of video game news, and it is tech related. So, it mostly kind of fits in the purview. Chilla, you got some news. Just out is the Nintendo Switch. Food.
It's like Swiss Miss or a Swiss watch.
Yeah, exactly. So, but that's Swedish, isn't it? I'm thinking. So you got something on that for your awesome thing of the week.
So, and I'm always looking for what the least amount of stuff that I can pack in my bag. I'm usually carrying multiple tablets, potentially multiple laptops, et cetera, et cetera. So when I can consolidate and reuse items, I definitely find it beneficial, whether it be what you were talking about, USB mics before the show, something that can kind of work with everything. Someone has figured out that the Nintendo Switch Joycon controllers that are used for the Switch, actually, because they're just basic Bluetooth connectivity, you can pair them with your Mac. So you can use the Joy-Con controller with your Mac. The one not so positive thing that I found interesting is the Joy-Con controllers are actually two separate Bluetooth devices, and obviously you can only have one Bluetooth controller. So you unfortunately can only pair and use one of them at a time, because I think Windows may also see them kind of as a keyboard. A Windows device, you can take and Bluetooth connect it and then remap the buttons and keys and whatnot using some programs on Windows. But I like the idea. I'm probably not going to need, from a mobile gaming perspective, single joystick, four buttons. I think it'll get you through. I'm interested to see. I'm guessing someone's going to come up with something that lets you kind of map the two together. Or maybe even Nintendo will update it, because I'm guessing it, I would think two devices connected simultaneously, it would be easier if it was just when they were attached together, just one. But I thought it was a kind of a cool way. You can, if you're taking your Switch with you in your bag, and you're also taking a Mac, and if you're like me and you carry lug around a controller with you for mobile gaming, this is kind of gives you an alternative to that.
I like that. Yeah, well, you know, more and more of these consoles have been like pretty standard. Mm-hmm. And I can't say that we've been terribly surprised, you know, for things like this coming up. So that's great. I mean, well, even like the tablet itself seems like more or less like an NVIDIA Tegra tablet that runs this entire thing for the console. So that's awesome.
Well, I wonder if that'll make it easier since it's an NVIDIA device. I wonder if we'll see, not that we'll get direct ports, because I obviously they don't want to belittle their device, but I could see them. Wouldn't it be interesting if Mario Run came to the Switch? Like, I wonder if you'll see some games that actually start off on mobile and then move to the Switch.
Yeah, maybe like, or maybe like a big boy version of it, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's in the long run. So from there, I have kind of a video game tech AR kind of thing. Related as well. I got last week. This is Chachi's fault, by the way, because he was hanging out with Missy on a video shoot a couple weeks ago, and she says, "Yeah, you should probably pick up the Pokemon Go Plus." And there it is. I've been rocking it for about a week now, and I have catched so many of the Pokemans out there. It's really like it's the simplest Bluetooth device, Chilla. It runs on a watch battery.
Nice.
Like it's that simple, right? And it connects, and all it is just that's a button right there, and it let me see if I can get it to do something. It just kind of lights up a little bit. Blue if it's a Pokestop, green if it's a Pokemon, yellow if it's a Pokemon you haven't seen yet. And for scale, there it is right beside the Pebble 2 watch, which is kind of nice. All you do is you get a little Pokemon Go Plus icon in there. You press that, you hit your button here, it's paired, it's good to go. And you can set it to just look for towers, just look for Pokestops. So the biggest thing is when it tries to catch a Pokemon, it's only using the red balls. And so if you have Ultra Balls, was it Ultra and Super Balls?
Something like that.
It won't use them. If you run out of red balls, you're out of balls, and it won't try to get them anymore. So you can shut off finding Pokemon and say, okay, I just want to find stops. And this is something, you know, we're kind of using more driving around. It should be probably used for, you know, walks for the most part. So maybe we're kind of excessively getting more than we should. Although walking through the Walmart was pretty crazy because it was like flooded with Pokemon. So you'll get to these points where, oh, there it goes. There's a green one there because there's a Pokemon in the area. And I'm going to tap it. It's going to flash white as it's kind of attempting to get the Pokemon. And a flash red because he fled. He ran away. And it'll flash like multicolors if you actually got them or got the tower or something like that. So it's really stepped up, you know, like I said, the Pokemon game. You're able to put it on when you're like, you know, traveling or I know Chachi says, you know, he uses it when he's on the bus going to work every day, to and from every day. So he's able to pick up some of the stops, some extra Pokemon along the way, or even he's downtown. So he has it on and he just picks up everything that comes around the office, basically. Or you know how GPS works downtown, Chilla.
Like, oh, you
know,
drift.
Where you're just going to drift a few blocks away, especially if you're on like the 40th something floor like he is. So you just kind of have this mass like grab of potential things. Also, it will, you know, you get steps for that Eevee you're trying to walk so you can get the new evolutions without keeping your phone on. So it really kind of maximizes that kind of stuff. It's really cool for that.
You do have to have Pokemon running on your phone, right?
Well, it's kind of at that point, like you start it and you kind of run in the background. And one thing Chachi and I both seemed kind of iffy on was when does it stop? Because I wasn't terribly clear. And I'll look and be like, oh, I haven't got anything for a while. And I'll look and like, it's still running. Or no, it's not running. Sometimes because I would have it on and end up driving and end up like in some place where I don't want to be, you know, messing with this, like downtown traffic or something like that. And I'll ignore it for a bit and it'll seem to stop after you've ignored a few things. Right. Okay. Other than that, you know, but still the app's running kind of more in a background state. So I don't think it takes up quite as much as even like the in the pocket, but you still have your screen on mode that we're used to.
The screensaver upside down.
Yeah.
Like it darkens the screen.
But it's definitely if you're really big into the Pokemon game and it's we've been having so much fun with it and we're like, you know, taking detours and going on lunches and going to hit some gyms and stuff or Katie was part of the Pokemon Day scavenger hunt that we did last week, of course, right? Mm-hmm. So, but then like, you know, as we're doing this, I'm driving, so I'm not grabbing all the Pokemons everyone else is. Now I have a chance to maximize that as well. So
did you notice any, so what happens, and I actually ran into this, it surprised me this week, I actually couldn't catch any more Pokemon because my drawer was full.
Yeah, that happens all the time.
So what happens with the watch
the Pokemon, you couldn't catch any more because your Pokemon was full?
Yeah.
When you talk about your strategies, and that's a whole another game, which will probably be the AwesomeCast spinoff show. We do need like a whole Pokemon kind of spinoff show, I think, at this point, because all of us have different experiences with it. Obviously, you're managing your Pokemons different than I am. Chachi's managed them differently. Katie has been dumping out her potions on the side of the road, apparently.
I have to dump out potions all the time. I dump any raspberries I pick up.
Yeah, I had like 150 raspberries. I'm like, this is unnecessary.
But like right now, in it from a Pokemon perspective, I have 232 like stored, and I'm constantly having to decide like, okay, what am I going to drop? And I was actually at 250 2 days ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we'll have to have the Pokemon tips, tricks, and nuggets episode.
Yes.
All right. I kind of have a secondary awesome thing of the week. I already shared a little bit of it online, but I kind of want to get a deep dive into it maybe after the ad. Katie, what is your awesome thing of the week?
I got an awesome thing, too.
Mm-hmm.
I have Netflix may let you choose your own ending.
Mm.
It's not anything over here yet. I saw this in the Daily Mail, so it's a UK thing. They may start working on Netflix is working on technology that will allow viewers to choose how the story unfolds via their remote. So this will cause some of their shows to have multiple endings, so you get to pick. Maybe you wanted certain actor combination to get together, or maybe you wanted everyone to die. I mean, you can choose your own adventure. So this might be something, it's a pretty cool technology. You know, it's something we figured, you know, you kind of have in the back of your mind that eventually was going to be a thing someday, but it looks like it might be closer rather than later. So they're going to have to film a whole bunch of different scenes to make everybody happy.
Mm-hmm.
But it's kind of choose your own adventure book, but in TV form.
That's awesome. I mean, we already have a little bit of the story, the Telltale games.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the Walking Dead's, the Batman's, the, you know, whatever else. So it'll be live action, multiple scenes. You're going to have the Scooby-Doo ending.
Yes.
Could you imagine Stranger Things with, like,
oh geez,
all kinds of different choose-your-own-adventure points in it? And think about, like, if they spanned it across seasons, decisions you made in season one, you could have to go all the way back to
Wow.
Do you know how much as it is, just for video games, you know how much dialogue they have to record based on all your choices that you could potentially make? There was one of my classes in school was about, I don't know if it was so much meant to be game design, but it was more like interactive storytelling, right? Like things like the Telltale guys are doing, you know, and you have to like do these decision trees, right? And then you have to go back and record for all those decision trees, right? And it's really interesting. But now you have to take all that and say, we have to record entire video scenes for all of these. You're not seeing this in a blockbuster movie. I don't think.
No.
Right? For the cost.
And the plot holes that it could introduce. Like, like even to your point about video games, Knights of the Old Republic, the second one, I found a glitch in the game on Xbox and that's back when, like, this is the Xbox first one and they didn't really provide video game updates or anything. I found a glitch where you could drop something prior to a dialogue, and this was totally accidental, and I was days and days into the game, I got stuck in a dialogue loop and there was no way for me to get out of the conversation. And because you could only like save, I think 5 or 10 saved games. And I was saving so frequently, I had no way to get back.
Mm.
And I'm like, you know what? Okay, this game's over. Like, I just tossed the game to the side because I'm like, I'm not reinvesting all this time back in this game.
That happens a lot. Like, I have a Metal Gear Solid on PS1 where my save is right before like everything attacks you and you have no health. And yeah, it's kind of rough. It's kind of rough. So, sorry, I'm kind of looking forward to one of these other ones. All right, real quick, I want to give a shout out to our friend Slice on Broadway before I get to my awesome thing, you know, maybe gadget a week, I guess you could call it. But hey, big shout out to our friends supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza every week here, making sure that we get our studio guests fed and the party that ensues throughout the evening here. In studio here in Pittsburgh, making it a very, you know, grounded show, you know, despite it looking like Chilla is completely in a room with us with that look. We got him vaping. Look at that vape. Look at that smoke. It looks so real.
Yes. It's like I'm right in the room.
It's like he's blowing into my face. It's amazing. And the pizza is amazing too. Unfortunately, we can't send the pizza over the internets yet.
Ooh.
One day we'll be able to fax Chilla a slice of Slice on Broadway. Fax a pizza. Bobby of J-Town always wanted us to fax him a pizza on Boss Battle.
Because when we actually have the ability to teleport food, that's how we're gonna do it.
I mean, you know, just like Back to the Future too, right? So thank you so much to Slice on Broadway. Check them out at SliceOnBroadway.com. They've also been fueling our pay-per-view parties too. SliceOnBroadway.com, PJH_Slice on the Twitter, and check them out here in the Beachview area, Main Street on Carnegie, PA, or down at PNC Park, home of the Pittsburgh Pirates, which is going to be very active very, very soon. So I got a little bit of a gadget in the mail. This was brought up several weeks ago, and let me see if I can set up a shot first. Where did I post that? Hold on. Yeah, I'm completely multitasking over here. So our friends at Grip Gear, they're our friends now. So I got this stick here going on. This is about $100 on Amazon track for an iPhone. There was an unboxing video we posted on the Facebook Live, and we threw it over on the YouTube as well. This thing, I'm going to have a lot of fun with this thing, guys. We actually, if you watch the Scott from the Scare House interview, we played with it a little bit, and there's these moving shots you may notice while we're interviewing him. So this is, and I can't really get it kind of, it's not plugged in, this is a motorized track, and you put your iPhone on this guy here, and now you're able to do tracking shots with an iPhone or a GoPro. So, you know, nice time lapses, things like that. I had it attached to the back of the porch, and I was doing some kind of time lapse stuff around the, looking out over the neighborhood. I wasn't too crazy about how they turned out, but I was kind of getting an idea for how it works and everything like that. So look for Chilla. It's about the right size for us to connect that webcam to that I was working with. And actually, here's a little bit of...
Does the connector piece for the where the phone goes, because you can put a GoPro on that, you can put a phone on that, you can put a number of things in that connector. Is it one of the typical screw?
Yes, it is, actually.
So you can mount a Gear 360 to it.
You absolutely can. Actually, I did consider, can we put the Ricoh 360 on it? And yes, it is the right size for it. So we can use a 360 shot and put it on a track. Wrap your head around the possibilities there. Absolutely. Oh no,
so
absolutely.
You know that park that I took pictures from that's 28 floors above, or 28 floors above Market Square?
Mm-hmm.
There's also a outdoor section of that that might create some interesting shots.
The video I'm showing right now for you guys that are on the video feed, this is a time lapse, and once again, geez, what did I do? I think this is just going across the table, and I think the camera definitely shifted a little bit in the middle there. Again, time lapse, it took a while, and we got a whole 4 seconds out of it. So I'm going to have to, you know, kind of assess what our kind of time lapse capabilities are with this track. It's got 8 different speeds on it. So, you know, when you're using time lapse, I need to kind of mess with that a little bit. I'm going to see if I got, I should have another one here. No, those are my stripper dollars from Uber. But there are a lot of really cool options you can do with this. And I think, did we put that on Sorgatron Media? We did one too. But we could have a lot of fun with this thing. Yeah, it's very, this thing just kind of pops right off. And I haven't even used, because this thing you can take off the track. Whoop. And there's a little kind of another connector here. And it's just a turning device. So once again, kind of the 360 time lapse kind of thing. And again, you know, it's meant for video. Or you can really flip people out if you put the Gear 360 on this thing and just spun it.
Give everyone a headache because they'll be trying to look around and it's moving too.
Yeah, yeah. You know, it'd
be kind of cool to take that. Like if you were doing, like, what would have been interesting is when you were doing the renovation of the studio,
mm-hmm.
if you would have put that in the center of the studio throughout the entire renovation and just had it rotate and time lapse.
That could have been fun. You know what I mean? That could have been fun.
Because you would have seen you moving all around, moving stuff around from all the different angles. I feel like that spin thing is meant for it to go in the center of a shot and constantly pan the shot in a time lapse.
Oh yeah, absolutely. But I don't think like in the you know, the big 360 side, like a pan across a scene, basically, right? Mm-hmm. Rather than like, you know, thinking in that you know, full circle idea that we have been with our Ricos and our 360s. Here is, again, for you guys on video here, I did a couple of shots and just kind of looped it here in the studio, and just kind of turned it, and then I threw it into iMovie on my iPad just to toss them in. And again, it's a time-lapse kind of thing. Actually, no, it's not even time-lapse. This is all real-time. And just a couple of quick shots and just some subtle movements that look, you know, pretty good. You know, think whenever they're showing off like a restaurant or something like that. This is the kind of shot that they tend to use for something like that. So I think we can have some fun and some possibilities with this. Or just, you know, epic shots of you guys sitting on the couch with the microphones in front of you, you know, as was kind of tested in this shot too. So a lot of possibilities here. It's pretty easy to pack up. You're like, oh God, how do I stick this long track? Just slides right off, and you got two pieces, and it goes right into a bag pretty easily. But I'm not. That's it. So.
Sounds like it's rechargeable battery.
Double A's, but that's it has nice. A USB that you can plug into like a power pack.
Okay.
So you don't have to worry about the double A's. And it does have a remote as well. I just haven't gotten a watch battery for it. So I could set this up over towards the couch, say, and I don't want it just running back and forth the entire time. I can go hit the button and have it do it. The one shot, again, if you look at the Scarehouse interview, is actually here in front of me. I set it on the front of the desk and angled it up. So it's kind of moving up and down at an angle. It seemed like it was some decent results. So I'll have to play with that and make it look better. Also remember, like, you need to have some things like for perspective. You know, everybody's kind of sitting up against the couch and there's nothing else really moving in front of you, so it's really subtle. So that's, you know, something to think about in composition when you do it. So it's the Gear. Oh geez, I'm gonna screw up the name now. I just had it. The Gear, Grip Gear, that's the name, Grip Gear, the Grip Gear Movie Maker set. So thank you so much. And you know, full disclosure, they sent us this. Like, we did not purchase this. They sent one over. So thank you so much for them for that. Hope you guys check it out. And great for, like, again, iPhone and GoPro movie making. So check it out. And I'll put it away very quietly. Okay, let's get back to... Katie.
Hi.
What do you want to talk about here out of your list?
I found another job for Michael Sorg.
Oh no, because I need another one.
Yes, this one you don't have to do anything besides what you were already doing.
Okay.
It's called Wrapify. So Wrapify essentially wraps your car in one of those logos, and depending on how fancy you want a bit, how much of your car you want to cover, but they will pay you to drive around with a logo on the side of your car.
What?
Companies will pay you. Yes. And they just got a $3 million from Avery Dennison to pay for kind of their startup stuff. So Avery Dennison is a global manufacturer of adhesive materials. So they know what they're doing. But yeah, so you can pretty much any size companies out there, Petco, some, you know, smaller startups are on there. But they can follow, like, if you own a company, you could follow where your drivers are. And you can see what kind of areas they're covering in a little fancy map.
Okay.
Or if you're driving for them, they will pay you. What was it? Up to like $300 a month?
A month?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like So
you Wrapify your car and then you use it for Lyft and Uber.
Yeah.
And you're double dipping.
Yeah. If you do full, you can make anywhere from $264 to $452 a month.
And it says it's a trusted company by Lyft.
Mm-hmm.
So this must be, unless they're advertising with it. It's just basically they do this and you drive.
Yeah.
You just do your driving.
Mm-hmm.
And you're in a logoed thing.
Yep.
So there's another way. Oh, okay. And you are, it's based on how many miles you've driven.
Mm-hmm.
Holy crap.
Yep. It's 29 cities. So I don't know if it's in Pittsburgh yet, but.
Wow. Zipcar is a part of this. And when they say trusted by, they're saying these are advertisers, right?
I think so. Yeah. Because that's what it seems like.
Nothing very specific, but I can't imagine there being much about wrap coverage level. It's how much you get.
Mm-hmm.
Man, per month approximately. I mean, you have to be okay with this idea
mm-hmm.
in order to jump into it. You know, wow, that's,
mm-hmm.
that makes me wonder about the ones that I see in the wild now.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, a lot of those, I'm sure, like the Jersey Subs has a car that's all wrapped up. I'm sure that's for their deliveries, but I'm sure there's other ones out there that are definitely just ad-based.
Can I pick the ads? Because I feel like...
I don't know about that.
I feel like you need to kind of...
So do they send you, like, do they tell you what you're going to be advertising, and then do you have to, like... tear it off and put a new one on occasion?
I really hope this is professionally applied. I cannot, you know, I can't even apply my iPhone screen protector appropriately. I can't imagine applying something like this to my freaking car. So.
Yeah, I can just see it now that I would sign up for this and then I would be shilling for one of the adult businesses here in Pittsburgh.
Lion's Den. Blush, you know, adopt a car away.
Exactly. Me driving along with a blush campaign on the side of my car.
Yeah, that could get a little awkward.
They're not in Pittsburgh yet. I just looked.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's,
and yeah, sorry.
Our car is safe for now.
Yeah, and it looks like, I mean, just kind of looking at all the brands they have on there, the most, I don't even want to say it's controversial,
risky.
But the, yeah, is Budweiser, Bud.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, that's the only one I really
like. I don't know if I'd feel comfortable, you know, I would love, listen, so there may be some things happening in the near future around craft beer events, and I feel like I shouldn't pull up to one of them with Budweiser emblazoned on my mm-hmm. car.
Well, the bigger fear yet is... I think Doug Durda would completely just have to cut ties with you.
Oh yeah, absolutely. At that point,
yeah. The should I drink that? It yeah. Hey Doug, if you're listening, weigh in.
Yeah, yeah. Let me know about that, of course. So
it looks like they professionally do it. Like you take it good. In, and it's professionally done, so you don't have to.
Right, have some kind of body shop or something that does yeah. that for you. So, this just in, Wheels out in the chat room. Aaron says, awesome thing of the week for him. He just bought a blue snowball mic. He had a couple other options in there, and we were weighing in on it. It's like, man, just get a snowball. It's going to be the easiest. I don't know what these other brands are. I we know the snowball works. I have clients that use the snowball. I have that, you know, it's the thing to do if you're starting your podcast, if you're, you know, want to get up from whatever cheapo PC mic or your headphone, your iPhone headphone thing. What are you giving me a look?
Oh, because I was just going to tell you that since you've segued over into the fan submissions.
Yes.
We have a couple of them.
We do. We do. Tell us about it. Well, what's coming in this week?
Well, for starters, Rizz, our buddy Rizz, who was on the show a couple weeks ago. He was on Awesome Cast, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was there. He's been on here and there.
Yeah, he has the essential tool for capturing your road travel adventures. The crystal clear HD footage, seamless footage review and transfer, has built-in GPS, everything you ever wanted from a car dash camera, and it is now on our favorite place, Kickstarter.
There you go. It could be real handy for those that Uber and Lyft driving, or so you can catch your CEO in process of giving some really bad information about the company. I've been trying to put the GoPro in there, and I can't find a good way to do it. And then I got a suction cup thing, but it didn't have the plate. So I'm like stuck again. This actually does look really cool. And you can view it with your phone. It looks like,
yeah.
So it's awesome. But being on Kickstarter, it's well over the $25,000 goal. So you can pick it up. But once again, when do you get it? It's saying April, June-ish. for delivery. So hopefully there's no slide on that, you know. And of course, you know, for something like, you know, I'm working on stuff, it needs to kind of happen right now. So what was it? What was it? Somebody get, like, one of the samples they gave was somebody gets pulled over and they're like, oh, you were talking on your phone. And there's like there's a video of her like just kind of dancing with a candy bar instead of talking on her phone to show what she was doing exactly.
Yes, because that would be so much safer than
being. I was going to say, that doesn't seem safer what she's doing.
There are no laws against that.
Maybe a little more rhythmic, but not safer, right?
Yeah.
So, anything else out of there that really sticks out? Yeah, I like this I like this Lego set that he has that Brandon has in here.
Oh, the Women of NASA?
The Women of NASA Lego set?
Yeah.
That's great.
Go ahead and pull up the image of that because it's actually kind of cool. You need to get my face off of there. Or at least scroll down a little bit.
Waiting for it to load. Go ahead.
Okay. So yeah, it's the Women of NASA. So some of the famous names of women in NASA that I can't think of off the top of my head at this point. But
which is why we need a set like this, right?
Exactly. So
we know about the Women of NASA.
There's been a lot of talk recently about how, you know, women need to be recognized more for the stuff that they've done. And NASA was one of the things that they've talked about is, you know, going back into the heyday of NASA, a lot of the big developments within NASA were made by women. But those women's names were never mentioned in anything. A lot of the movie remakes and stuff, I know Kim Lyons touched upon this last week, that some of the movies and stuff that they've done about all of the space travel and NASA's advances throughout the years have all touched upon the famous men who've been involved in the projects, but never on the famous women. So Lego is now stepping up with this Women of NASA to kind of bring it back around to the fact that, hey, women can be awesome scientists and do amazing things as well.
Awesome. Go check that out.
Yeah.
Cool. Anything else in there to stick out?
Doug Durda had some really big news that he actually brought in.
What? Doug?
Doug Durda, yeah. Yelp buys No Wait.
We know those guys.
Yeah, we do know those guys.
No Wait, the main head guy from No Wait actually was down here in this studio several years ago in the early days of AwesomeCast. And look at him. So I'm starting to think, because we've had so many people in the studio that, you know, got bought by Yelp, you know, maybe in the WWE. I'm thinking maybe it's a studio bump at this point for people being on the show.
Like the mayhem
bump. So you want to get in your studio. So in the studio. So you get that good luck rubbing off on you and you get bought by Yelp for $40 million years from now. Right. So good luck. So great success story for those guys, a Pittsburgh based company, and seeing them do really, really cool. So
you should do a whole reel as seen on AwesomeCast. Show each, like, a clip of each person that's been interviewed, a clip of their interview, and then where they are now.
Yeah. An awesome casters, where are they now? Yeah, that works. I left the NASA women video running. Now it like looks like an episode of Cops. It's got real, real weird. So, Chilla, what do you got in here? What is going on with the iPad Pro?
So this is something that interested me, and every time someone does something with the iPad Pro and then it ends up on some mainstream media or billboard in New York, it gets a lot of press. So the Logan promo poster that's in New York City's Times Square was done on an iPad Pro.
It was painted on it?
I'm guessing it was drawn, because it does look like a drawn. It's probably a combination of tools that they used to actually make, and my browser froze. Oh, wow. It's a combination of tools they probably used to make it. But so also things like the Stranger Things like movie poster, that was done all on an iPad Pro as well. So where you see Apple now doing these commercials that are pretty much tweets about, you know, my computer has a virus or my laptop's running out of battery, blah, 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 and they talk about the iPad Pro being a real computer, I think they should do a whole segment on, look at all this other stuff that you probably didn't even realize was done also on the iPad Pro. So that was a pretty cool play for things that big media production type things like this poster that was done on an iPad Pro.
That's awesome. That is the biggest push because it started off kind of as a consumption device rather than the creator's device, and maybe, you know, especially with the Pro with the pencil and everything like that. It's kind of come around on that, and it is a very powerful tool. I mean, we were just talking, having a session for boot camp a couple of weeks ago for PodCamp, where, you know, we're like, hey, this is the stuff you can do on a laptop, and I'm continually, like, these trips coming up, I'm continually trying to think, can I just go with an iPad? Right. Mm-hmm. I eventually turn into, nah, you should probably make a laptop, right? Because I mean, I'm definitely on the high end, but like, you know, if only I wasn't in X type of business, I would love to just roll with an iPad and completely could in most aspects.
We had a discussion when I was looking at buying a new computer because generally I don't need a whole lot of horsepower behind
computer
because of the work that I do. It's more, you know, it's not really high end like what you're doing with your video work. But at the end of the day, I like having the keyboard.
But there's other options even for that.
There are other options.
Whether they be Chromecasts or something else, Chromebooks or something else, right? So, but I mean, the only hang up there is you're starting to use a little bit more Photoshop, but again, all the Adobe products from Android are coming over, so that can meet somewhere in the middle, perhaps. And there is the option. There was like a beta of a web-based Photoshop that was supposed to be applicable to the Chromebook. I haven't heard the latest on that yet. But
when we were talking about the blue microphone earlier, the Snowball, they make that blue raspberry device that's both USB and Lightning. So you can take and throw a Lightning nice condenser mic on there. And that's something I think, who was it? Andy Anako did one of the MacBreak weeklies off that device.
Oh, yeah.
It sounded great.
It sounded amazing. I mean, again, it seemed a little pricey for what it was a little bit, but it was looked really good. You know, sounded really good. You know, not that I think everybody, like, you know, that like Wheels that we were talking to earlier, that's just kind of starting off. But if you're at that point where you need something portable and do want to bump it up to the next level, you know, it's definitely recommended. You know, I was just chatting with somebody today. They were looking for an adapter, and I was just like, man, you know, this one works all right, but you should probably bump up to the next one, you know, because you'll get a little bit more quality out of it. You know, it's a matter of, like, you know, $50 ranges. You know what I mean? It's not like, you know, the okay one versus the really good one is like $800 now. It's $150, and that's a lot more accessible if you really are serious about the thing you want to do. You could be a serious podcaster, audio podcaster, and probably shouldn't spend more than $500 getting ready or upgrading, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like, for most people that do audio podcasts.
I'm gonna put a quick plug in here for PodCamp Pittsburgh. Crystal O'Connor over with Libsyn. She did our podcasting sessions last year for PodCamp, and she was talking about putting together, you can completely do a podcast from your mobile device. Libsyn, just again, she works with Libsyn, and they have a lot of products available that make it possible, and it's all relatively inexpensive. And how many of us have, you know, iPhones or Android devices that are competent enough to handle that?
And it's all about kind of upgrading that a little bit too. It's just so awesome and accessible. So, Katie, can you tell me about the Land Rover?
Man, they got all kinds of cool stuff in the Land
Rover. I love the tech in the car idea. And again, like, I have a 2012 car that, like, I feel like, yeah, I can talk to it, but that just means I yell at it more.
Yes.
You know, so.
That's the thing we do. We yell at cars all the time.
Exactly, right?
So it's got some basic cool tech. It's got, you know, the cool thing inside, a 10-inch horizontal screen, very exciting. It's got a commute mode, which learns your routes, and then once it learns your routes, it'll tell you how to get there better. It'll suggest routes depending on traffic and accidents, and it'll also send messages to your coworkers. It's got the normal park assist, pedestrian detection, automatic cruise control, super cool. But then it's got this thing called an activity key, which is a rubbery strap for your wrists, so you can leave your car keys in your car. Like, if you're out being athletic, running in the woods, and you just need your wristband. And when your wristband gets close to your car,
being athletic, just running around in the woods.
Yeah, you know, I'm in the woods running around.
So I'm sorry. So what was the wristband do again? I got distracted by the idea. Like, I'm just running around.
Hang on. If I'm in the woods and I'm being chased by a bear, I would want to have that be able to unlock my car so I can open the door and get in without fumbling with my keys.
And so. let's say you got a tiny dog who can't make it into the back of your car. You can lower the rear suspension. Look at that.
Oh, man. We got to get in our car now.
Well, No. I was going to tell you that one of the things that I shared was actually a Toyota, I believe. Oh, Nissan. It was Nissan X-Trail. And I came across this on Facebook. The website, when I actually went to the website, is not in English at all. Like, it's in Eastern, like, it's
Probably Japanese. Since it's Eastern?
Or is, well, yeah, it's either Japanese or Chinese. Right. One of those
either way.
Symbolic languages that I can't read. But yeah, they have for dogs, and it has, like, this pull-out ramp that the dog, you know, small dog can get up into. It has a pull-out washing station for the dog, and it has a bunch of other things specifically for dog people. So I actually tagged your mother in it, Mike, because she is a dog person.
Oh yeah.
And I thought that she would absolutely appreciate it. Yeah, there they are.
Just hanging out. The four dogs concept. It's awesome. So it opens up. Yeah, we're watching it. Oh no. They show more.
It's just the glory shots
of a dog being absolutely muddy right now.
The dog gets absolutely muddy. You don't want the dog getting into the car muddy. So it has a washing and drying station.
Mm-hmm.
It has a pet bowl station. It has a video system so that you can monitor from kind of like a baby monitor that you put in the back seat. You have it set up for your dog.
Come on, give me the juicy part. Do we get to put on Disney movies for them as well?
I didn't see that part of it, but I did see, like I said, they had the video stuff where the kid was talking.
Oh, wow. It does look like there's an entertainment center back there for the dogs.
Yeah,
wow.
That's what it is. So yeah, here he is.
It's all padded. It's all like a,
yeah,
wow.
So there's the dog shower. It's a 360 dog shower. Jeez. You can vacuum the dogs to dry them so that you've got a dryer system in there.
And it's a little ramp for the dog.
Dog to get up in there. It's all leather in the back, so it's easily washable. So you can wipe it down. It's got a speaker system so that you can talk to the dog, and there's additional
Wait, we need a speaker system to talk to the dog? And there's a self-serve dog food.
Yes. I was looking at this thing going, I kind of want one for my dog
now. As absolutely, positively have to spoil your dog on the go, this is the thing for you. I left that little video of your owner in the back. That's great. Built for families. Some people are just going to get this and throw their kid back there. Wow. That's amazing.
Based on the rubber strap you guys were talking about, I think, Sorg, you should take a picture of your wrist every 6 months, and in 10 years, your wrist is just going to be bands of different stuff.
You've noticed this pileup having here, huh?
You're going to go to the next wrist.
This is inevitable. I always like to put on the other one. No, I'll put it on this one. This is where, and the great thing is, when my phone is away, And I had it originally because there's a clip one on too, because that's how I saw Chachi was doing it. So you can clip it on the band for your smartwatch. Then when you hit the button and you want to find out exactly what happened, the message comes to your smartwatch. It's so it's like they're talking to each other, right? Because you don't have a text feedback to this. So you get the text feedback on the thing next to it. I'm wearing two Bluetooth devices. Let's get our head around that too. I like the idea that when I get in my car and realizing, because I do this kind of thing in my head every once in a while, I get in my car, it turns on, it's got the sync, so it does the Bluetooth, right? So my phone is automatically connected to two things on my wrist already. My stereo and my automatic OBS port reader thing. How many devices can we Bluetooth, Chilla?
I think it's at least 127.
We're going to make a run for that. I'm telling you. I mean, this is like, and I feel like I'm like, am I overworking my phone at this point? Because on top of that, then I go like driving and I'm using, like, I'm already using the Pokemon thing on slide on the background. I'm using GPS. I'm using maybe an Uber or Lyft if I'm on the job there. It's, you know, when is my phone going to melt from all the technology that it's communicating with at a time? So, like, actively communicating with, right?
Oh, this is the, so from Apple, the official Bluetooth specification states 7 is the maximum number of Bluetooth devices that can be simultaneously connected at once.
Hmm.
You might actually be...
However, 3 to 4 devices is a practical limit depending on the devices and profiles that are being
That
used.
Might be why, because I do notice the automatic, like, kind of disconnects every once in a while.
Yes.
But we got the notice from Automatic saying, hey, you might want to upgrade because we are not going to be able to guarantee the newest Bluetooth technology.
Well, just think about it, though. When you get in the car, you have your watch, you have your Pokemon Go device,
mm-hmm.
you have the sync for our car in general, just the Ford sync.
Yeah.
And then you have...
Is there anything else?
The driving app that you were just talking about, the
mm-hmm.
that device. So you've already got 4 things automatically attaching to your phone when you're sitting in our car.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if we're close enough to the house, anything that you would have Bluetooth synced with the house,
which isn't much. Like, I got a speaker over there. That's about it. And that doesn't always. Wait, what does? No, Apple TV's over Wi-Fi, so I don't know. Anyways, yeah, it might be maxing out a bit.
And I'm guessing that's why you're seeing certain technologies go, like Sonos. Sonos is Wi-Fi. And you can connect a bunch of speakers simultaneously and mesh them together. I'm guessing that's why you're seeing other ways to connect. I mean, even the Gear 360 does like a Wi-Fi direct connection. It doesn't. It pairs with Bluetooth, but then the majority of its data is like a miniature hotspot created
kind of like AirPlay, right?
Mm.
Like where it kind of shoots through all that technology. Yeah, just shoots through all the technology. Yeah, interesting. Well, we'll see. We'll see as I slowly add things onto my wrist and my car. When we hit the wall on this thing, right? So we'll see. You know, soon I'll have I'm sure smart glasses again. Somebody did offer to let me play with their spectacles, so I'm gonna have to line that up soon too. So you know, could be everything. Could be a little bit of everything. On that note, anything coming up event wise? Oh, is there some stuff happening?
There are some events coming up. Yes. Okay. I actually went through and culled through some local event stuff for tech because I'm trying to make this a little more proactive.
Mm-hmm.
So we have our PodCamp Bootcamp Blogging with Squarespace coming up on the 15th. So that's going to be next week with Amanda Narcissi teaching everybody how to use Squarespace. There is a focus group with Google on the 17th.
Oh, that was interesting. Free swag, by the way.
Yes. That's at the shop over in Homewood.
The shop, by the way, I believe is a venture with Kip Mueller.
That I believe so. We would go
to their Monday Unstucks, yes. and he does a lot of stuff around, you know, the startup weekends and everything. So definitely a place I need to check out. So
yes, Pittsburgh Presents Robotics is coming up at the Pittsburgh Athletic Association, and it's brought to us by the Pittsburgh Entrepreneurs Forum, and that's on the 23rd. Where is Black Tech in Pittsburgh? Is coming up on April 1st, and that's also going to be at the shop in Homewood. That is
put together by a friend of the show, Kalani Cook, over at Work Hard Academy Pittsburgh.
Yep. The PAPA 20 World Championships. So anybody who's interested in amateur pinball, their World Championships are coming up on April 5th. We've done some work with ReplayFX and PAPA with some of the stuff that we've done.
Got an interview with those guys on Awesome Chat from a few months ago.
Yep. So they're having their nice big event coming up. The Millvale Music Festival with our friends, The River's Edge, and the community of Millvale, actually, is coming up on May 13th. Brian's working on getting a lot of local talent and local businesses working together over there in Millvale. So that's going to be some great and fun and exciting stuff. I'm helping out in a couple of different manners, I guess, with that. So that's self-pimping. It's going to happen. It's going to be awesome. And then Kashira Moffitt, who presented at PodCamp Pittsburgh last year, she is doing her 2017 Hustle Her Way Summit. And that's going to be June 9th. And that is over at Alpha Lab. So lots of fun tech stuff coming up in the coming weeks and months. And if you have any events that you'd like us to mention for our calendar, hit us up. We have an email that we're going to be setting up, and I'm letting Sorg know of this now, that events@sorgatronmedia.com.
Okay.
So that way, let us know, and we'll share it on our calendar.
Preferably
tech events or something having to deal with tech related, since that's what we do for the show. But yeah, so that's what's coming up.
Awesome, man. Go hit her up on, bug her on the Twitters at RebelliousFlaw as well.
Yes.
I'm making sure you get the plugs.
Yes.
So awesome. So with that, let's wrap it up. Hey, Chilla, what's going on with you? Chilla on the Twitter, chillatech.net for your readings.
I'm looking at where the shop is so I can figure out how I can get to this Google event.
Mm-hmm. In the dock?
Mm-hmm.
There should be.
I found the link and I found the address.
Oh, okay. So you're looking up a map now.
Yeah, I'm looking at Google Maps.
Nice.
Maybe here for the Google event, you're checking out Google Maps?
Yes.
That seems proactive.
Yes.
So hit up Chilla at Chilla on the Twitter for your techie needs and gadgets and such.
Yes, yes. And reach out if you want to talk tech. Talk about mobile. And then another event, too, coming up at the end of the month is the Samsung announcement. So stay tuned for more information coming from that.
There you go. Katie Dudas at Katie Dudders on the Twitter, and also Scarehouse Podcast.
Yeah, dude. I was just swearing. I've been everywhere lately. I was on the Broadcast Podcast a couple days ago with
nice.
Kim and Natalie. That was fantastic. I can't wait to hear all their amazing interviews. They got some great people.
Mm-hmm.
Some great ladies. Can't mm-hmm. wait. Was very honored to be part of that podcast, to be honest with you. This weekend, I will be at the St. Patrick's Day Parade. And then after that, on Sunday, I'll be at the home show. I'm talking about social media with Scarehouse.
There you go. At the home show? Like the home
yeah,
and garden show?
Yeah, you know, do things. Pittsburgh Magazine was like, hey, you know stuff going on in social. And I'm like, sure.
Well,
they reached out to Scarehouse and we're like, yeah, we know stuff.
Well, there you go. Watch out for Virgil.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, it's Virgil! Make sure I get a picture with him.
Mm-hmm. No. $20. You got 20 bucks on you?
I'm going to find money. I'm going to use that 20 bucks that Chilla gave me.
There you go.
Invest it wisely.
Of course, at Sorgatron on the Twitter, sorgatronmedia.com for all the podcasts that we're doing these days and so much more. Thank you everybody for joining us. AwesomeCast.net. Thank you for Wheels, Trey, John, Kraus, and anybody else that might have missed out there in the chat room tonight at live.awesomecast.net. Join us every Tuesday at about 5 p.m. No, I'm sorry, I looked the wrong thing. 7 p.m. Eastern time, maybe some other time zone. Actually, isn't that is 5 p.m. like Mountain, isn't it? 7 p.m. Eastern here at live.awesomecast.net or on the Facebook page. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you to our awesome chat room. You've been our awesome audience. Have an awesome week. What did I forget? It's fun. Yeah. Well, that was fun. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com. Hey, everyone. It's time to talk tiki.
Tiki talk!
Tiki talk.
Welcome to Tiki Talk.
We're getting hammered.